Hi, it's Hopkey. In this screencast, we're going to be looking at a new component that's shipping with Pano2VR version 6, and it's a map pin with radar. Okay, so it's actually for a pro project. So this is what we've got open, Pano2VR 6 Pro. It already has 5 nodes added, all the hotspots have been linked, and under the user data, I've added the titles to all the nodes, and all the nodes have had their north set as well. If you need to know how to do any of that, please check out our documentation. All right, so moving on then, we're going to open up the skin editor, and this will show you that I've already started a skin, a project, and all it has so far is a PNG image of the map, and this is the map that we'll have our map pins on. So I'm going to open up the component toolbox. In the component toolbox, you will see map pin with radar. There's 2 of them. One styled that has a text box styled for the silhouette skin. The other one has got a text box styled for the simplex skin. To add a component, you can either right button click insert component into skin or just double click. And there you go. That's the component added. To add your map pins, then all you do is go to Pano2VR and you will drag in the nodes from the tour browser into the skin. But as I don't have a lot of skin screen real estate, what I'm going to do is undock my tour browser and then go back to the skin editor. And you can see now, because I've undocked it, the tour browser is now on top of the skin. So now I can do it. Right, so to add your map pins, select the map and now start dragging in the pins where roughly where they should be. There we go. Don't stop to rearrange or to place the map pins correctly. If you do, because everything is selected, you'll be moving everything. You're better, let's put that back, you're better to wait until you've finished. So let's just carry on doing this for the minute. I've finished. I'm going to select the skin canvas just to deselect everything, and now I'm free to just click on any of the pins and move them to where they should be. There we go. So that needs to be there and that one down there. Okay, done. Also, make sure that all your map pins are a child of the map element or the map picture. All right. Once that's done, what you can do now is generate and view the output. So I'm just going to put the tour browser back and redock that. And I've left a little bit of a gap at the top of my screen. The reason being is I want to keep the skin editor open, but I want to generate the output. So from the skin editor, I can do Command S on the Mac to save the skin. That will be Control S on the PC. And I'm going to do Alt Command G to generate the output from the skin. You can do Control Alt G from the PC. And when I hit the return key, Pano2VR generates the output. Now, the reason why I've left this gap here is because you can see my browser is now opened behind Pano2VR. So I've got this gap where I can click it to get focus. And there we go. There is our map with our map pins. Everything's working. We have all the tooltips showing. And not only that, when we hover over a point hotspot, we also get the corresponding tooltip showing in the map. There you go. So that's quite cool. Right. That's basically how to add the component and how to use it. Stay tuned if you want to know how the nuts and bolts of this works. Right. So still here? Good. Right. So let's move on then. How did this work? Right, well, if we expand the component, you'll see it's made up of a couple of graphics, a node marker that's been renamed to marker template, and that also has the text box. Okay, now a node marker, as it says, is an element that we can use, but when it's renamed to marker template, it allows us to do this drag and drop. It takes on a whole new function, and it's great for doing things like this. We can drag and drop it in. So that needs to have its name marker template. And also what's happening is that the marker template is cloning these graphics. We've got one with marker normal and then an active. So an active node in the map will then clone marker active. It's just what we've called them. They could be any IDs, and you can select it from a drop-down box. Okay. Also, because we're cloning these graphics, if I was to change the shape of this graphic, you'll see that we'll change it real-time in all of the nodes. So if I was to make it 50 pixels wide, you'll see that I've changed all of the graphics at the same time. Let's go put that back. Okay. Also, with the marker active, it rotates with the panoramas. And that's because at the bottom it has a modifier, rotate pan north. That's why it's important to set the north in all your panoramas, and then this will be pointing in the right direction. Okay, that's covered. Right, how does then the marker template's title show when we hover over a point hotspot? Well, good question. Basically what's going on here is under the hotspot proxy ID, we have a couple of curly brackets. Now, I know that's not going to mean a great deal right now. However, under the visible, we have a condition. Well, there's actually two conditions. Mouse over parent equals true, visible true. In other words, when we mouse over the marker template, which is the parent element, when we hover over it, that condition says make the text box show because the visible true. We've also got a mouse over equals true. In other words, when we mouse over the text box, it will become visible, which sounds a bit odd if it's hidden to start with. But if we take a look at, say, node 5, which we drag down, what happens is if we look at the text box for it, those two curly brackets have now turned into the node ID for node 5. And the hotspot proxy, let's go back to that, the hotspot proxy basically means we've made a physical link to any point hotspot pointing to node 5 to this text box. So if I hover over the hotspot, it's like hovering over this text box. And as we saw earlier, when we hover over equals true or mouse over equals true, the text box shows. So that's how and why that's working. The other thing we can do is, you know, we've got these graphics, we could actually swap these graphics out. So let's just expand the hide template. And as an example, I've got an arrow. I want this to be my active element and pointing in the right direction. So what I'm going to do is, rather than change and having to remake everything, because obviously when we pulled out all these node markers, they're using this marker active and marker normal, all of them. So if I wanted to change this, I would have to delete those and do it again. But if I keep the ID the same, so let's copy that and add the ID of the arrow to marker active. I'm just going to call the actual marker active something different. And as soon as I do that, you'll see that we're now cloning the arrow because it's called marker active. There you go. I'm just its size is I'm just going to change its size to match everything else, so 30 by 30. Okay, and then of course what I needed to do to get it to point in the right direction is to give it the modifier rotate pan north. That's it, that's all I needed to do. I can now save the project, generate the output, and we have a look now. What we've got is, instead of that little ring, we've now got the arrow, and when I click on a hotspot, we go to where we've got to go. There you go. That's the new component, map pin with radar, and thanks for watching.